In this screencast, I'm going to be showing you how to send files from the local server, from the local machine to a remote server. Of course, we're going to be using SCP. We're not going to be using SSH because it's a different, it's not necessarily for you to use SSH. That's one of the biggest problems that many people make. They try to send files using SSH, at least for now. I don't know how to do it with SSH, via SSH, if that's possible. But if you want to send files from your local server to your remote server, the better option will be using a tool called SCP. So the command to send the files as, on your local machine, you don't need to be logged into SSH. Just open your terminal. And then you're going to type in a command, SCP. I use verbose because I want to see everything as it's going on. And then on my local server, I have to identify on my local file system. I have to identify the file that I'm sending. The file is seated in my users directory. My directory, and then in a directory called sites, and the file is fnbbe.zip. So that's the file on my local machine that I want to send right onto the server. And then on the, you space out, so that is SCP space verbose, just to see everything going on, space the file on your local machine, the directory where it's saved, and then space, and then your remote server details. So you're going to use your username the username of your remote server at the domain of your server, and then colon. Okay, you put a colon and then you slash and then put the file directory where you want this file to be sent. So I'm sending it to my home directory on the remote server under the directory called situkaco. Called stukako, and then slash under the public underscore html directory into the directory called bbe. So that's the command that you use, and then from there you just press enter, and then you watch everything as it goes on. So the system, before it starts sending the file, it's going to ask you for the user, the password for the username you used in your command that you typed onto when you started, for your remote user that you used in the command. So mine is, I won't tell you, I'll just put it in right now, and then enter. If it's all well, the next thing you see, the file is gonna start sending. As you can see here, this is the percentage of the sent file so far. It will run up until 100%, then you will know the file has been sent successfully to your remote server. So that's it for today, guys. I hope this helps you and saves you time surfing the internet finding the solution. SCP is the right way to go. If this helped you, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to like this video. Don't forget to share it with a friend, because this is how you keep the channel running. Thanks for watching, guys. That's it for today. Peace. Mia out.